So have you ever seen one of these before?
Yeah, you have, right?
This is a stoplight. This stoplight is interesting, though, because it opens up. This is the actual size of a stoplight. So here, you can see that in our stoplight, we have two different kind of bulbs. These are bulbs made from light-emitting diodes, and this is an incandescent light bulb, which you're probably very familiar with. And these bulbs have very different properties, which make them useful for different things. So let's do a little experiment with our different kinds of light bulbs. So here's a string of incandescent bulbs. And I want you to take this hand crank, which generates electricity, and I want you to start cranking it slowly and keep going until you get the bulbs really brightly lit. You start cranking, you have to crank pretty hard, see? Now try it in the other direction. All right, so you have to crank pretty hard, but the light bulbs light up no matter which direction you crank in. So let's try with our LED bulb instead. So this is a string of LED bulbs. So we start cranking, and you can see that it starts to light up. The red ones do with very little cranking. And as I go more, we get the rest of the bulbs lit up. Now let's try going in the other direction. You can see that none of the bulbs are lighting up in this direction. So that means that LEDs require a certain directionality in the current in order to work. The other thing is, what color light bulb lit up first? Yeah, the red bulb. That's because LEDs are made of semiconductors that are comprised of chemicals. And whatever chemical we make determines what color it's going to be. So if your audience is familiar with chemistry, you can say, if it's with nitrogen, we can get a blue light. Whereas if it's with arsenic, we get a red light. And so by controlling the chemistry, we can determine what color light bulb we're going to have. This is a color strip of LEDs, and I'm going to plug in the battery here. And you can see that even though when I started, all of the bulbs were clear, now they're all different colors. And when I unplug it, notice what happens. What did you see? That's right, the minute I pulled the battery out, the lights didn't turn off. They stayed on for a couple seconds. Which one turned off first? That's right, the blue one turned off first. Which one stayed on the longest? The red stayed on the longest. That means that red LEDs are lower energy than blue LEDs, and so they take less electricity to run. So one other little experiment that we can do with the LEDs, and this is a color mixer. So I'm going to turn it on, and you can see that this bulb is also white. So if you turn these dials, if you turn the red one, you can see that the light turns red. So just try turning a few of the dials and see what colors you can mix. So again, this light bulb looks white with the glass, but it's the chemistry in the LED that determines what color it's going to be. That's different than this incandescent bulb, where the incandescent bulb is white, but the blue glass makes it look blue in the string of lights. So here's a range of colors that we can get with different LEDs. So this is the Roy G. Biv LED display. So let's go back to our traffic light for a minute. So we talked about how LEDs are more energy efficient than incandescent bulbs. Why would that be good for traffic lights? What other applications do you think that would be useful for? So one other thing I'd like you to notice, if you put your hand near this yellow light, you can feel it feels pretty cool. But if you feel the green light, it starts to feel pretty warm. That's because incandescent light bulbs give off a lot of energy as heat, and that's in contrast to our LEDs, which don't give off much energy as heat. That makes LEDs much more energy efficient because they're not losing energy in the form of heat. So if all of our LEDs, our traffic lights, are made with LEDs, they'll be much more energy efficient and cost less money to run.